Hello, I'm going to be streaming Dishonored 2 today. I wasn't intending to do this, but a friend of mine convinced me to do so. I was just going to, do it myself, or play it myself, but might as well share it with the world. Why not? So this is the Venerable Brotherhood. I usually stream The Witcher. The Witcher 3 is the current game I'm enjoying streaming the most. But I'm going to be streaming, again, Dishonored 2, as I just picked it up and I'll be playing it for the first time. So let's switch on over and play it up. Oh, I closed it though, so I'll be switching over once I get it started up. Just got find it on the list of Steam games once more. I started it up and got some of the, I got some of the settings. That is the word I was looking for, settings set up. So, I might as well start playing it. I will switch over to it. Hopefully it will run properly. I don't need to see your logo, Bethesda. I know who made the game. Or who published it would be more appropriate. But we should. I'm glad it's loading faster the second time, though. No, I have never played it. I played the first one and I absolutely adore it. It is one of my favorite stealth games. Very much very close as well to Metal Gear Solid 5 as well. But this one has that perfect blend of combat and stealth. You play the entire game stealth, or you can play the entire game combat, or some mix in between, and you can switch them on the fly. So I'm going to be picking up the tutorial right away, just to get things started. It's been a while since I've played Dishonored, so I'm going to hopefully get things up and running. Dunwall. As Emily Caldwin, ruler of the Empire of the Isles, you have numerous enemies. Your father is Lord Corvo Atano. Oh, no. Yeah, it's Corvo. In the years since you took the throne, Corvo has spent many hours training you in the arts of stealth and combat. So, apparently this game is obviously...
I remember training with my father in the years after the rat plague. Someday, he said, our enemies will come for you.
Yes. This takes place after the first one, obviously, and that mouse sensitivity is garbage, so I'll be switching that out. Yeah, I need controls, mouse and keyboard. That one's really low, so we'll try 60. Yes, I'm going to pull that 70. Still not good enough. Forgive me while I just mess with some settings. Again, I wasn't intending to do this stream, but you know what? I think I will just continue streaming this game. Usually good enough. So apparently you're still harvesting whales for whale energy. That's kind of Dishonored's thing. It is a Victorian era game. The era in technology is kind of the Victorian era. It's just
the sounds and smells of Dunwall never change much.
One of the biggest things
is my city.
Is they discovered a incredible power source in essentially whale oil. Significantly more powerful than in our world, but it's essentially. It's explosive. That's how powerful it is. Ah. Hello, Mana Cakes. Yeah, you convinced me to stream it, so I'll have some fun streaming it, along with playing it for the first time. So I'm just doing the tutorial right now. So yeah, they harvest whale oil from whales. It becomes so... It's kind of their pivotal energy source. So right now we're playing Emily. Emily, the Emperor.
What training regimen does Father have in store for me today?
All right, Majesty. Let's see what you can do.
It's odd having Cormo have a voice. He didn't have a voice in the first one, I don't believe. But yeah, I'm playing as Emily. She's the Emperor, and apparently Cormo has been teaching her the ways of, well, the assassin. I might change that around.
I'll have to climb up and over. If I get going fast enough, I could slide beneath that.
Yeah. So.
Yes.
Just a little tutorial. Hurry. To get back into it.
Time to sprint, vault the obstacles, then slide under.
Just a little game.
Easy as cake.
Just a tutorial to get back into the rhythm of playing Dishonored. Oh, yeah, Emily.
What's next?
She was just a child in the first one, and she was kidnapped as her mother was murdered. Blamed for the murder. Oh. Essence swim. The water's beautiful in this one. Dip. Love just the Victorian era, kind of just after the Industrial Revolution started taking place in this era. But that slight edit. Whale oil being huge power.
Only I could spend every day running and jumping. Now let's see how quick my feet are.
So the game is very much about parkour.
Come to me.
And I missed.
I can reach the edge with the right jump.
You've learned well. Let's see how quiet you are, young lady.
So I might keep, stealth. Farther away from them, blah blah blah, above them or at the edge of the Still, stay to shadows, don't walk so close.
Sneak up on me, if you can.
So we're gonna have a nice visceral just whale viewing today. Ugh. So yeah, it's definitely it's not pretty. It's not nice, but they do harvest whales, and it's kind of gross. So Corvo's over there. So I switched the lean to not be toggle, because it's one of the things I do not like most times, is toggling. It's a console trope that makes things easier, but to me, I lose control of it. So I don't usually enjoy leaving those options on. I believe the two characters...
Move up quietly and apply a chokehold.
In this game you are able to play as either Corvo or Emily. I don't
if
know...
If you're quick enough with the chokehold, that's one...
Control. That's weird. But, yes, they should have entirely different playstyles.
That's my girl.
And entirely different spells.
Let's see how quiet you are, young lady.
They have entirely different repertoires of abilities.
Most people won't notice you if you're above them, overhead.
Didn't see anything at all.
So, yeah.
Don't make any sound.
So I'm still...
Quiet as a lynx stalking a gazelle.
Which character to play. In the first one, you play as Corvo. And you have a certain playstyle. So that would... I'm assuming the playstyle is going to be very much akin to him.
Building. Your crossbow is quiet.
Oh, I'm supposed to shoot the actual bottle, not... Shoot the bottle, not the indicator over the bottle. Ooh! That was a flaming bottle. And then I need to shoot... Oh, I'm shooting the little red thing on the turnbuckle. Oh! That released a weight. That's really cool. So yeah, a lot of this... world is about... Oh, I'm out of arrows. It's a good thing I... better at shooting. A lot of this world is about environmental kills as well. Like, you can interact with certain things to set them off and get environmental kills. or you can not kill anyone. Like, you have the ability to go through the entire
game. Time for some more weapons and combat
without
training.
Killing.
Let's beat each other up, shall we?
Right.
Yes.
Okay.
You hit hard. That's
Normal
my
attacks.
Daughter.
Should be
when
able
someone
to
swings a sword at you, block.
I just don't remember which control. That's
block with your blade. Good.
That's slightly
well
annoying.
Done. Very good.
Yeah,
You've
I know
got
the
a natural
fire.
Instinct for fighting. If you time your block right, you'll throw an enemy off balance.
Just as the enemy. Yeah.
You're quick.
I mean, you have to block.
Smart move.
That'll
stop even
block
the
anyway.
Most black-hearted killer. You can choke an enemy out, even in combat.
That's good to know. So if I block you, and then I can grab you. Huh. Interesting. That'd be useful.
Go for the fatality.
So what do you want me to do? Enemies off balance. Oh. Nice. So I go into essentially a combo.
Feel better knowing you can take care of yourself. When trouble does finally come, you're ready to fight.
So yeah, I haven't decided which character I want to play first, either Corvo or Emily. So we completed the tutorial, which has got me back up to speed of how to play the game. campaign. So I have no idea when I have to actually choose which character to play, or if I get the choice, but it always sounded like I had the choice. So, after the campaigns. So, yeah, I'm not going to be doing easy. I'm into the first person action games, hard for veterans of Dishonored, for players who enjoy a challenge. I'm probably going to be playing medium, just to be the default perspective. I usually enjoy doing that the first time I play games. It means it's not super challenging, because I can usually probably play the game on hard my first time through. But it allows me more to enjoy the game without being frustrated at the combat mechanics. So I will be playing on medium. I don't want to start the tutorial. I just did the tutorial, so no, I'm good. So, a long day in Dunwall. Today marks the anniversary of the death of the Empress Jasmine Caldwin. So that's Emily's mother. This is 15 years after. That's also good to know. So Emily is 15 years older, so is Corvo. Visitors from across the Empire of the Isles have journeyed to Dunwall Tower for the occasion. So I don't know when I will be getting the choice to choose between the two characters, or if I switch between the two, or I have no idea. All I know is you have the ability to pick between the two.
Why do we celebrate the anniversary of her assassination? 15 years ago, in the middle of a plague that nearly destroyed Dunwall, a paid killer assaulted the palace where I was born and stabbed my mother in the heart.
Doubt.
In the aftermath, the men who sent the assassin tried to use me as a pawn in a game of power. They would have succeeded, but my father, Corvo Atano, hunted them down and cut their conspiracy to pieces. All these years later, am I the ruler my mother wanted me to be? Now, we face a new crisis. A monster the papers are calling the Crown Killer has been picking off my enemies and dressing it up like my father and I are responsible. I don't know whether to get on a ship and sail to the opposite side of the world, or to have everyone around me executed.
It's a little dark. So also in this game there is essentially the chaos system. The more violent you are, the
Watch
more
your
chaos
step, Majesty. I'm not looking forward to all this ceremony today.
And the city reflects, or at least in the first
your
one.
Your signet ring. There. You're ready. Thank you, Alexei.
This one also has
open the doors.
At least some version of the chaos system, where the more you kill people, the more damage there is to the city, and the more.
All hail her
get.
Imperial Majesty, Emily Caldwin.
But
loyal subjects, we're going
so
through a difficult time, but today we honor my mother, the late Jessamine Caldwin. May her memory survive through the ages.
So I don't know.
Emily.
You look tired, Father.
Every year, I think the anniversary of Jessamine's death will be easier, but it never is.
I wish Mother was still the Empress. I don't think I'm very good at this.
You're still learning. Don't worry about the rabble-rousers, and we'll catch the Crown Killer, eventually.
People are saying it's you, that these assassinations are a misguided effort to protect me.
No. Someone's trying to make us look guilty by targeting your enemies.
I wish I could just run away from all this.
Sometimes you do. You think I don't know about your nights out on the rooftops? Courage. The ceremony will be over soon.
Royal protector and father. I should have passed a law against that combination of titles years ago.
See, I just don't really I mean, this confirms that Corvo is actually Emily's father, which wasn't really stated.
Your Majesty, before we begin the day's observances, we have an unexpected visitor.
The Duke robots.
Of Sir Konos.
Ramsay says the Duke is bringing special gifts.
That's intriguing.
Disgrace, Luca Abel, Duke of Sir Konos!
Weaponized.
Mechanical soldiers? Amazing.
What is this, Ramsay? I didn't authorize those things.
Yeah. Their heads look like the guy.
Your Imperial Majesty and Royal Protector Corvo Atano, a native of our homeland. Sirkonis offers condolences on this sorrowful day and gifts to remind you of our nation, the rising star on the southern horizon.
We thank you, Your Grace.
Save your thanks. For now, I give you the greatest gift of all, family. I present the lost sister of Jessamine Caldwin. Your rightful empress, Delilah Caldwin.
Impossible.
My mother had a sister. My dearest niece, hello.
It's not true.
My father was Emperor Yuhorn Jacob Caldwin, and Jessamine was my younger sister. At the time of her death, I wasn't ready to make myself known to you, and I was forced to leave Dunwall. But now I'm home.
If you really are my mother's sister, you're welcome to stay as long as you like.
Little Sparrow, blackened by bad memories, I'm here to relieve you of your crown. My father's promise, whispered in secret so many years ago, is now fulfilled.
Watch your tongue. Emily Caldwin is the daughter of Empress Jessamine Caldwin.
Royal Protector, how naive to think you could get away with these murders. Living in my palace has protected you, but that's over. Hear me, all of you. Your rightful empress has returned.
All hail the Empress Delilah, first of her name. Arrest Emily Caldwin and her father for the Crown Killer murder.
What?
Oh!
Can't steal my heart.
She has wicked powers. She took the outside mark. Please. Okay, so lots of crap just went down. So the older sister, who somehow returned but wasn't actually the Empress before, is back, I guess, and she's taking over in a coup? I'm also assuming that she's behind the Crown Killer murders in the first place. That makes the most kind of sense. But there was also in the DLCs in the first game, there were these witches that had another type of power, and a lot of it dealt with, like, bramble thorns. And that's what it looked like that the older sister used on Corvo to restrain him. So I'm assuming that she's part of that power source? But then she also, on Corvo's left hand, there should be the mark of the Outsider. The Outsider is essentially a deity. He's very much chaotic neutral. He kind of likes screwing with stuff, and he's kind of a deity of Outsiders. That's why he's the Outsider. But it looked like she just ripped that mark off of his hand, which is crazy. On the mark of the Outsider is also the source of all of Corvo's abilities. And presumably Emily gets that mark if you play as her. So it looks like this is the choice. I get to play as either one of them. So I either get to play as Emily Caldwin, ruler of the Empire of the Isles, trained in stealth combat by her father, or I get to play as Corvo, the legendary royal protector to the Empress, and figure of infamy from the time of the Rat Plague. So yeah, Corvo was framed for the assassination of Emily's mother, which was also his lover, which they didn't really... It was hinted at in the first game, but it's now definitely confirmed that Emily is his daughter, and yeah, so it wasn't really sanctioned that they were having relations, but Corvo was blamed for her murder, and he was hunted down, and he unraveled a plot to assassinate Emily and take over, and depending on how you played, you either murdered everybody, or you could have found non-lethal ways of dealing with the thing. So actually, I played as Corvo in the first game. So I think I'm actually going to be playing as Emily, because I haven't played her before, and I think that sounds fascinating to play as a new character. So I think I'll actually decide to play Emily. Unless, you have a... I don't know if you have an opinion, Mana Cakes, as to who might be cooler to walk through, but... I know you're not familiar with the first title, but yeah, I think I gave along with the background, a little rundown of the game as well, myself. I'm definitely leaning towards Emily, just because she's new, and her powers will be also new to me as well. So I think from the gameplay mechanics from previously, that his powers were more akin to what they were in the first one. So, yeah. Just thinking that she should be fun. So I'm assuming I just click a button and... Oh, good, there is a confirmation. I always enjoy it. It's like, this is one of the big decisions, and it's like, are you sure? This is where this kind of confirmation is appropriate. It's like, are you sure you want to pick a game-changing confirmation? It's like, yes. So I get to play as Emily.
I'll cast you in cold marble.
Oh! That takes care of him. I'm assuming that would have happened to Emily.
Over time, you'll come to love me. Perhaps someday you'll see me as the mother you lost. But until then, you'll be kept out of trouble.
I'll lock Lady Emily in her chambers, and then I'll bring her to Coldwell prison until her trial.
He just kicked her in the face.
My father lost it all when I was a boy, so now I wear this uniform, and I send 20-year-olds out to patrol the Rose Gardens instead of drinking with the men from the shooting club.
That's nice.
Captain Ramsay, I heard shouting. Lady Emily, what happened?
Good night.
I'll be all Captain Mayhew.
Yeah, this is definitely a violent...
No!
That's the Royal Protector's fancy weapon.
What kind of sword folds in half?
You left the sword out, and you assume that Emily is defenseless, that she's just a woman. You're gonna pay for that.
There's a legend in the Tower Guard
about the Empress's last resort, a safe room inside your chambers holding enough gold to buy a good-sized island. They say that this ring is one of the only two keys to exist.
Okay. I'm assuming Corvo had the other one. I believe he was wearing the same ring.
What happened? Alexei. The throne room. Father!
Apparently you're coming back to your senses.
Nothing I can do alone. I need to get out of here.
So, let's take a look around. Whited out, but interesting view.
Dial. Ramsay knows what he's doing. The man's moving up in the world. He's old blood. One of the good families.
So
now that he's helped the rightful emperors take the throne, the Ramsays are going to be back in fashion in Dunwall.
Yeah, one of the old families. So yeah, I kind of assumed the nobles would be moving in. Eat to regain health. That's pretty much akin to the old game. Just looking about. Grandfather clock, set alarm. Oh, I could probably use that as a distraction.
Should I just spin it and pick a place to hide for a while? I need time to think.
Okay, that's nice little Easter egg there. Just close out the typewriter. That is an interesting typewriter. It's very large. Design, but anything about letter from advisor Helmswater. Empress, we face yet another murder, and I cannot remain silent on this matter. Strange is it not that all the victims have openly opposed you? If not strange, then oh so very convenient. Is there anything you wish to tell me, Majesty? How can I be an advisor if you don't include me in these most sensitive endeavors? I feel I must be the only person in Dunwall who doesn't know the truth about the Crown Killer. Don't leave me out in the cold. I remain your trusted servant and advisor, Yanora Helmswater. Alright. Ship launch protocol. Empress, if the Royal Protector's shakedown crews will launch the ISS Jasmine Caldwin just before the anniversary of your mother's passing. Pending your approval, of course. So, this is a ship that's leaving either now or has already left. But if the Royal Protector hasn't done the shakedown, on the platform we'll have a bottle of King Street brandy tied to a long tether that you will release to swing out against the hull. What you say during the ceremony is, of course, up to you, but here are some ideas intended to serve as food for thought. May a brisk wind hurry you to shores near and far and fair. May you shelter your crew from the perils of the terrible ocean. May you always sail for crystal, true of heart, and homeward bound. So, yeah, essentially he wrote a speech for him, her. His faithful advisor, Wainwright. Anything else on here? Earth, harvest, nets, rain, wind, darkness, high, cold, ice, heaven, sea, timber, and sun. Oh, the months! Interesting, that's a very interesting name of months. And there's 4 weeks, 7 days in a week. And there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 months in every year. 28 days in every month. Absolute certainty of days. What about the typewriter? Okay, so it's just a little interactable toy. Alright. Beautiful painting. I've always enjoyed the art in this game. First game, but it appears that they have outdid themselves in this game so far as well. Creepy heads, though. Gazelles on some gazelle type game or animal. Apparently, I've got to set an alarm.
I used to hide frogs in this old grandfather clock to drive the housekeepers mad.
Wow.
I thought life was complicated back then.
That's evil. haven't done, I'm gonna have to check the door.